Who Pays for a Tax? Part of our weekly lecture series on government intervention. This title slide has a quote from Oliver Wendell Holmes that says, "Taxes are what we pay for civilized society." In this video, we're going to talk about who bears the burden of a tax, and also we might mention what is a subsidy. I do want to put in a plug for myself at this point that in the spring semester of 2021, I will be teaching a class on the history of taxation. So if these lectures are something that you're interested in, please, we'd love to have you in that class as well. One of the things that happens in our taxation model that's kind of interesting to reflect on and a little counterintuitive is that who writes the check to the government, whether the consumers or the producers actually pay the government for the tax in the market, whoever does that, that actually has no connection to who bears the burden of the tax. In other words, who absorbs more of the price change of the tax. So this difference is called the difference between statutory incidents, in other words, who pays the government, and economic incidents, in other words, who gets the higher share of the price change. And so let's explore what does determine who really pays for a tax. Now, usually both suppliers and demanders will pay a share, and we call this share the tax burden. Here we see our supply and demand model with before a tax, where the triangle area here marked by A and B all indicate the economic surplus of this market when it's operating without a tax. Now, if the seller has to pay a tax, that would result in a leftward shift of the supply curve. How we determine the actual price with the tax is we draw a line from the y-axis over to the equilibrium point. That's sort of the equilibrium point that we see there. And then we go straight down. Now, the key is that once we get to the equilibrium point, we want to make sure we draw up and down to make sure we intersect any of those lines. The top line will be the price the buyer pays. The bottom line will be the price that the seller pays. The important thing to remember is that in a tax situation, the buyer is always going to pay more than the seller. So the price the buyer pays is going to be higher than the price the seller receives. So in this case, the seller's paying the tax to the government. The supply curve shifts left, and as you can see, the price for the buyer is above the equilibrium price, the price for the seller is below the equilibrium price, and the quantity is below the equilibrium quantity. If the buyer pays the tax to the government, the demand curve will shift left. That leftward shift of the demand curve means that the equilibrium point is actually going to be lower this time, and it's where the price of the seller is. And again, we want to draw up to get to the intersection with the old demand curve, and that's the price that the buyer pays. And then if we go down to the bottom, that's the price that seller pays. Now, I just want you to pay attention to the indications on the left axis, on the y-axis, and on the x-axis, because I'm going to go back and show you that all of those things look exactly the same. Where the demand curve and the supply curve intersect the y-axis and the x-axis, they look exactly the same. The price the buyer pays is the same whether the buyer pays the tax or the seller pays the tax. I'll go back again. The price the seller receives, the same no matter whether the seller pays the tax or the buyer pays the tax. The quantity that's produced in the market and sold in the market is the same whether the seller pays the tax or the buyer pays the tax. In other words, whoever pays the tax has no impact on the pricing and the quantity that comes out of the market. Now, what we notice here in these situations is that the gap between the equilibrium price and the price the buyer pays is greater than the gap between the equilibrium price and the price that the seller receives. In this case, in this specific case, this means that the buyer bears the greater burden of the tax because the gap between the equilibrium price and the buyer price is larger than the gap between the equilibrium price and the price the seller receives. So that means that the buyer or the demanders bear the larger burden. What does cause the greater burden of attacks? Well, it's actually tied into elasticity. You may want to take a moment now and just sort of think about what you know about elasticity, what you can review about elasticity from our previous lectures. Again, the simplification we're doing in terms of demand curves is that the flatter the demand curve, the more elastic the demand. Now for supply curves, it actually does turn out that the slope of the supply curve does equal the elasticity of the supply curve. But for demand curves, it's just an estimate. Anyways, what we say in this class is the flatter the supply or demand curve, the more elastic the supply or demand. When you think about what that means that the more elastic supply or demand means that the larger change due to the price change. In other words, the flatter the curve, the more responsive either supply or demand is to the price change. What that means is that the more elastic curve pays less of the tax burden because it's easier for either suppliers or demanders, in this case, to leave the market and purchase something else. So when we think about who bears the tax burden, it's the curve that is less elastic. It is the curve that is steeper. So in these cases, if you notice, the demand curve is steeper, has a slope that's more negative, than the supply curve has a slope that's positive. So in this case, the buyer will pay the greater share of the tax burden. But we can think about a different situation where the demand is more elastic than supply. And if demand is more elastic than supply, whether we shift the demand curve or the supply curve, we'll see that the seller pays the larger share of the tax. So really, it's all tied into the elasticity of the supply curve and the demand curve. One note about our tax system. Our system of taxes is not set up to maximize government revenue. Let me have you participate on the Slack channel with your thoughts on why our tax system looks the way it does. So, whether buyers or sellers bear the burden of a tax has no relationship on who pays the government. Instead, it's the relative elasticities of demand and supply indicate the greater burden. I will deal with subsidies in a later video. Thank you.